Hey everyone, it's Brett Hornby here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Yes, I did get some sun this past weekend, as I was at the greatest outdoor show on earth, the Calgary Stampede. However, in this video, now that I'm back inside, and let's just say it's a little bit of a blue Monday, because the Monday after the Calgary Stampede is over, usually it's a little down in the Calgary area, but it's time to move on. But things are going to get a little more exciting for hockey fans this week. As it's appropriate, I got to have this blue light on, not because it's the Monday after the Calgary Stampede. But we're going to talk about the Seattle Kraken expansion draft. Lists were released. Protected lists for all, well, the 30 teams, the Vegas Golden Knights, are exempt. But as a Calgary Flames fan, talk about how the Calgary Flames are looking ahead of the Seattle Kraken expense draft and give my thoughts and feelings on who they protected and who they exposed, and ultimately who I think will be taken by the Seattle Kraken and what the Calgary Flames should potentially do on that asset that they lose if indeed it happens. And it's definitely lots of crazy rumors as I was out at the Calgary Stampede that there were definitely some trades and side deals and players decide to waive their no move-it clause. Definitely some big names on there, but it all has salary cap implications. So I'll bring out my notes here and let's talk about who the Calgary Flames first protected. And it's no surprise. It's basically what all hockey pundits have said. And I speculated, I agree with, that the Calgary Flames are going to go with the 7-3-1 route, where you protect 7 forwards, 3 defensemen and a goalie. The other option is you can protect 8 skaters and a goalie. And there actually was a few teams that have done that, where they protected more defensemen and fewer forwards. But in my last video, where I talked about that it's worth the risk for the Calgary Flames to expose Mark Giordano, well, that's exactly what has happened. As the Calgary Flames have protected Michael Backlund, Johnny Gaudreau, Matthew Tkachuk, Sean Monahan, Elias Lindholm, Dylan Dubé, and Andrew Mangiapane. That's pretty much been the consensus 7 forwards that the Calgary Flames were going to protect ahead of the expansion draft. I get no argument out of me on those 7 players. And thankfully, Milan Lucic, a couple months ago, said he agreed to waive his no movement clause so he can be exposed. Because if he did not agree to waive his no movement clause, as much as I actually like Milan Lucic as a player on the Calgary Flames, it was a business sense knowing that his contract might be a little too hefty for any Seattle Kraken to take on. It would have meant one of those forwards that we would lose him for sure to the Seattle Kraken. So thank you, Milan, for waiving your no movement clause. The only difference that I saw that was different was Craig Button on TSN, which I'll give a slight disagreement on, that I remember he said that the Calgary Flames would protect Glenn Godwin over Michael Backlund for his 7 forwards. So other than swapping out Michael Backlund for Glenn Godwin, because Glenn Godwin is potentially available for the Seattle Kraken. I know he's one of still highly touted prospects. For the Calgary Flames right now, I do not think the Seattle Kraken we're going to think about taking him, despite, you know, the potential and the cheap hit. I mean, Seattle's trying to build up their team to be a competitive team with some named players while being value-driven at the same time. So that's the forwards. No argument out of me. I think many hockey fans and Calgary Flames fans agree that those were the 7 players that we should protect. But this is where it gets interesting, as we protected 3 defensemen. Ultimately, it was Rasmus Anderson and Noah Hanifin. No brainers. We ultimately decided to protect Chris Tanev over Mark Giordano. And I made that video last week talking about that we need to expose him, because Mark Giordano, as great as a Calgary Flame he has been for the Flames, being their captain, won the Norris Trophy a couple years ago. He is 37, going to turn 38. At the start of next season, in the final year of his contract worth $6.75 million, there was no way we were either going to do the 8 skater option and expose more forwards to protect Mark Giordano And if ultimately we had to protect Rasmus Anderson and Noah Hanifin as our younger defenseman, I don't think we would want to expose Chris Tanev either, because he definitely would be a more appealing pick for the Seattle Kraken, and the fact that we spent a lot of money and commitment to him last year in free agent frenzy. So those were the defensemen we had to protect. The only positive about Yusuf Valimaki being injured all last season and not playing at all last season, talking about the 1920 never-ending season, that it made him ineligible to be available for the Seattle Kraken. So that was the only one positive there. And then goaltender, well, no-brainer, Jacob Markstrom. He has a no-movement clause. We weren't going to ask him to waive it, because one of the conditions that he wanted in free agent frenzy was to go somewhere where he has a no-movement clause, and the Calgary Flames were able to offer that. While the Vancouver Canucks, they had to say bye-bye to him. Ultimately, I think Vancouver's better off with Thatcher Demko, and we have Jacob Markstrom, and I'm going to keep saying he is probably the best goaltender that we've had since Mika Kiprusoff. So those are the 11 forwards, or players, I should say, that we have protected. To recap the forwards, is Michael Backlund, Johnny Gaudreau, Isaac Kachuk, Sean Monahan, Elias Lindholm, Dylan Dubé, and Andrew Mangiapane are the protected forwards. The protected defensemen, Rasmus Anderson, Chris Tanev, and Noah Hanifin. And the protected goalie, and Jacob Markstrom. This was exactly the players that I figured the Flames were going to go. And the fact that that was what many hockey pundits were speculating that we're going to be protected by the Calgary Flames. So, who's available to the Seattle Kraken? Well, the forwards that are available to the Seattle Kraken, well, Milan Lucic, I can see him potentially, maybe, possibly being picked up despite his hefty cap hit with the bonuses. I mean, he still has 2 years left at $6 million, but with Edmonton retaining $750,000 of it, maybe they could still maybe take him. I mean, he has, you know, over 1,000 games NHL experience, has been to the Stanley Cup Finals. He's come to the Vancouver area, but I do not think he is likely going to get picked. Well, they got Derek Ryan, who is an unrestricted free agent. He is from the, you know, Spokane, Washington area. I think the Seattle Kraken are still going to talk to him and maybe try to hope that he's available as an unrestricted free agent when free agent frenzy begins. So I think they might still pick him, but they might try to pick someone else who I think is going to be the player that's going to be picked and then sign a free agent frenzy. Other players, well, Josh Levo, he's an unrestricted free agent. He was a little bit of a disappointment this year, but Calgary has better options. Matthew Phillips, well, he's actually available. He's still one of our young prospects. I don't think Seattle's going to go that way. Byron Fraze, another depth, you know, they're all dime a dozen that, you know, there's just another organizational depth player. Glenn Godwin, which that's who Craig Button thought we should protect over Michael Backlund. I mean, Michael Backlund, yeah, he makes over $5 million, but I think at this stage of his career, he's actually a step below almost knocking on the door to be a Selke nominee for best two-way defensive forward. I wasn't willing to take that risk, but Glenn Godwin's available. How about Zach Rinaldo, an unrestricted free agent? He's just another grinder that, you know, there are a dime a dozen. Same with Justin Kirkland, he's a free agent. I know that Calgary recently signed Brett Ritchie ahead of the expanded draft. I know that, I think, actually when you hear that he was signed, and, you know, I think Brett Ritchie would still be a useful bottom fourth line player for the Calgary Flames for the next season. I think one of the rules that you hear for expansion is that you have to have a certain number of players under contract that's available. Because I know Seattle, I think they have to take 20 players that are at least under contract for next year for their selection process. So Brett Ritchie and then the other two forwards, well, Buddy Robinson, another depth forward, and Dominic Simon, which I actually, no, he's still available. But I was thinking of another player. Yeah, Joakim Nordstrom. He's the player that's going overseas, but he's not listed. So those are the forwards that are available. I think the top two forwards that Seattle might take a look at would be Milan Lucic and Derek Ryan. But I think we're likely going to lose a defenseman, as this is who is available. Well, defenseman, well, Mark Giordano. That's the biggest name that's available for the Seattle Kraken to pick. And if you based on rumors and speculation, It is sounding like the Seattle Kraken is likely going to take part here now. He would definitely be a solid community player, a leader. He's been a captain here since after Joel McGinley won the Norris Trophy for the Calgary Flames back in 2019. He is still a step behind from those days a couple of years ago, but he's still a top four defenseman for all 32 teams in the NHL in my mind. I think he is the best prospect for the best player, I should say, for the Seattle Kraken. And the thing is, that worst case, if we lose him, suddenly we'll have another $6.75 million to spend in free agent frenzy. And may I suggest, if indeed we lose Mark Giordano to the Seattle Kraken, maybe the Calgary Flames would suddenly be in the market for Ryan Suter or Keith Yandel. I'm going to put that out there. I might make a video go more in depth than that if indeed we lose Mark Giordano in the Seattle Kraken expansion draft, that the Calgary Flames should make a play for both those players because they recently got bought out. And yes, Ryan Suter, he is actually related to Gary Suter. If I look at some of my analytics, there is some people that will watch my videos that were old enough to remember when we had Gary Suter. He is a nephew of that. Other players on the defensive side that is available is Michael Stone. I doubt that Seattle's going to take Michael Stone, and I think that's another unrestricted free agent that actually the Calgary Flames should consider bringing back next season to be a bottom depth defenseman. Oliver Shillington is another player that other pundits say if Calgary isn't going to lose Mark Giordano, they might consider taking Oliver Shillington because he's still a fairly young defenseman, 23, 24 years old. I mean, he looks like a steal when we drafted him late in 2015. But, you know, he's been in and out of the lineup. It seems like Oliver Shillington, for the sake of his career, he probably could use a change of scenery. So I could either see Mark Giordano, if Seattle wants to go with a proven veteran and leader to start out their roster, to immediately be in their top four, or maybe to have some depth. And then that's the other thing we got to think about what the Seattle Kraken is once the expansion draft is done. I will plan to make a video. Probably won't be until the Friday after I've had time to look at the whole roster and any trades that get made. I mean, Seattle's going to pick, you know, 30 players that are all NHL ready. They're all not going to be in the lineup right away. I mean, some of these players that Seattle's going to take, they're either going to be flipped for currency for draft picks or prospects or do a favor for other teams. So that's the other defenseman. Then Nikita Nesterov, well, he's already committed to go back to Russia, so I don't think they're going to take him. And then same with Alex Petrick, who's another prospect that, or just an AHL-level player that he didn't play up with the Flames this past season. He was more in Stockton. So that is the available defenseman. I can see Mark Giordano most likely he's hearing, or maybe Oliver Shillington. Then goaltenders, I don't think we're going to lose a goalie. That we protect Jacob Markstrom. Tyler Parsons, well, he's another AHL-level goalie, and Seattle's going to have tons of goalies to pick from. They got a very, very tempting choice with the Montreal Canadiens, as they actually decided to protect Jake Allen and expose Carey Price. If they're willing to eat $10.5 million cap hit for the next 5 years, they can get Carey Price. And then, as of this recording, it sounds like the Seattle Kraken is going to take Chris Drieger from the Florida Panthers and sign to a 3-year deal that I think pays him $4.5 million. I think not too probably for over the term. I don't understand that, right? But Seattle Kraken is looking to already talk about Chris Drieger. They got an abundance of goalies to pick from, so I don't think Tyler Parsons or Louis Domingue are going to be picked for a goalie for the Calgary Flames. So looking at the available players, I think the most likely player that's going to be taken is Mark Giordano, which, I mean, it wouldn't necessarily be the end of the world for the Calgary Flames. I know that we need to look at replenishing our defensive depth and maybe get some more defensive prospects in the system now that, you know, Rasmus Anderson, Yusuf Välimäki have, you know, graduated to be the Flames. And I know another young defenseman that we signed from the KHL, which I understand he's going back to Europe, is Alexander Yelichin. But I think if we lose Mark Giordano, it would buy us another $6.75 million in cap space, where we should suddenly be in the market for a Ryan Suter or a Keith Yandel, who recently got bought out by their respective teams. Maybe we can get them a little cheaper, and then use some of that other cap hit in addition to picking up our bottom six and find a backup goalie. So I think Mark Giordano is likely going to be picked. Second pick, I actually would think I'm leaning towards either Oliver Shillington or Milan Lucic, but I think we're likely going to lose defenseman. Then I'll put Milan Lucic just ahead of Derek Ryan. But I think Seattle, what is likely going to happen is they're either going to take more likely Mark Giordano or possibly Oliver Shillington as the Calgary Flames pick, and they were going to probably sign Derek Ryan in free agency, which at the end of the day, it's not going to be that much of a devastating loss, not worth giving up a couple of picks or a prospect just so we can keep him. And I think some general managers from 4 years ago have learned that you're only going to lose one player, and then the reason that the Vegas Golden Knights was able to build up their team a lot more was after the expansion draft, you know, with the trades and that. We're going to hear any of those side deals that will happen at the expansion draft on Wednesday. So my plan is I'll recap the expansion draft when it comes, you know, all the picks, get my feelings on the roster and any trades. Of course, if Calgary does anything, I might make a separate video to go more in depth on that. But that's who the Calgary Flames have protected and who the Calgary Flames have left exposed. So I'm going to ask, what do you think of the protected list and the exposed list, and who do you think ultimately the Calgary Flames are going to lose to the Seattle Kraken? I think it's either going to be Mark Giordano or Oliver Shillington, depending on what direction the Seattle Kraken want to go when it comes to picking the defenseman. And I just say, if we lose Mark Giordano, we're going to have even more money to spend on free agent frenzy. But, I mean, if we lose Mark Giordano, I'm honestly going to, you know, thank Mark Giordano for his time with the Calgary Flames, you know, leading, being great in the community, and, of course, winning the Norris Trophy. He is second in franchise history for games played only behind Jerome Ginlon. Don't know if you would say he's a Hall of Famer or someone that's worth having his number 5 retired by the Calgary Flames, but he definitely is, you know, top 10 or even top 5 if you stretch it far enough to put him a best defenseman of all time. And then, speaking of drafts, I mean, the other video that I plan to make next weekend is I'll recap the entry draft for the Calgary Flames. As looking at the entry draft for the Calgary Flames, I mean, they are finished. They are going to draft 12th overall in the first round. As of this recording, there hasn't been any trades about any picks yet. I mean, the only pick that they don't have of their own is the 4th round pick, because they traded that to the Los Angeles Kings when they picked up their forward during the stretch drive for the 2020 playoffs. And the Calgary Flames also have an extra pick in the 3rd round from the Edmonton Oilers in the James Neal and Milan Lucic trade, which, for the Calgary Flames' point of view, that trade's definitely starting to look even better just on the players alone. Heck, the Seattle Kraken, they can take James Neal in the expanded draft, but I doubt they are not going to take him unless the Edmonton Oilers maybe say, we'll give you a couple first-round picks, and I don't think that's going to happen, but hey, you never know. Just what is. So anyway, as I say, if you want to follow along this Calgary sports fan's journey, home of the Flames, Hitman, Roughnecks, Stampeders, I also do talk Calgary sports on my YouTube channel, but I also do variety of non-sports content when I've had the time with personal blogs, attempt to call me, and also do share my spirits on the road or a sporting event. I've been doing a little more logging on the go, but I think the next couple weekends, it's going to be mostly NHL and Calgary Flames content, because we got the Seattle Kraken expansion draft to look forward to. Find out who the Seattle Kraken take to build up their team, what they do with those assets, and who ultimately they take from the Calgary Flames. And then you got the NHL entry draft and the free agent frenzies, I meant to say, to look forward to. And then, of course, Calgary Stampeders. They're going to be playing starting in August, finally, for the 2021 season. So there are going to be a lot more Flames and Stampeders content here in the next couple months. So anyways, as I say, as I've all, sounds like it'd be interesting to watch to follow along this Calgary sports fan's journey. You know what you do? Just make sure you hit like and subscribe. I also have my other social media links down in the description below. So as I say, what do you think of the protected list? Who's available for the Calgary Flames? Who do you think we're likely going to lose to the Seattle Kraken? And I guess you can also throw in, what do you think about all the other craziness that is ahead of this expansion draft? I think I'll elaborate a little more on that once the picks get made and say who was available and did they take him or they didn't take him. Let's say Carey Price in Montreal. Who would have thought that? But I just want to say thanks for watching. Go Flames go. Release the Kraken, and I'll see you in the next video.